Hey there, I just wanted to pop on here before we go any further with today's lesson to say two quick things. One, this lesson is designed for beginner drummers. So if you're a brand new drummer, this video is tailored for you. And if you're an intermediate or advanced player, most likely what's going to be covered in this video, as you may have already seen in the demonstrations, is kind of way below your skill level. Okay, the second thing I wanted to mention is for you beginner drummers. Before you go any further, I'd love you to hit pause in a second and go to the description below this video. There's two links there. The first one is the drum transcription for each groove that I demonstrated in today's video. Download it or print it out, use it to practice. That is the main thing. If you could take anything away from today, grab that PDF because you know it's designed to help you practice. More than anything you'll get in this video, having those grooves written down is a tremendous way to practice. And then the second thing for you younger drummers, your new drummers, there's a second link in there. So if you've never read rhythm or drumming notation before, I have a PDF down there specifically to help you learn how to read the drum charts. So you can grab that as well. Download it, print it out, whatever you want. But please, before you go any further, hit the pause button and grab those two links below. All right. Otherwise, let's keep going with the lesson. Part three in our open hi-hat sub-series of the beginner series that we're doing here on the drum shed. This is cool. This is a big step up from the first two videos. And the reason being is you may have noticed, especially if you're reading the chart right now, we're using smaller subdivisions of notes. So we've got 16th notes in our grooves now, whether that's like a little 16th note on an E or an in a snare or the bass, or maybe it's a one-handed 16th note groove, or you may have noticed, we have not covered this yet on the channel, but you may have noticed the last groove, two-handed 16th notes on the hi-hat. For you absolutely brand new drummers, if you've been learning drums exclusively with me here on the drum shed, you might be like, what is going on there? If you follow the PDF, you'll see that there is like R's and L's, R being your right hand, L being your left hand, telling you how exactly to play that two-handed 16th note groove. But I promise you, I do have a whole video lesson coming up real soon on how to develop two-handed 16th note grooves. So I promise that's coming. But you know, let this one little drum beat in the open hi-hat part of the beginner series be your kind of introduction into that new technique. So you're kind of getting two new techniques today. You've got the open hi-hat technique and a little nugget of two-handed 16th notes. So that's pretty cool. So as always, as I mentioned in part two, make sure if you're brand new that you're freestyling this, meaning don't plug it in with the metronome just yet. Go note by note, get comfortable with the physicality of each groove, the physicality of lifting your hi-hat foot and then closing it for that open hi-hat note. Get comfortable with the flow of each groove. You know, take your time. And as always, once you can do each one of these grooves anywhere between 4 to 8 times in a row, 4 to 8 measures, 4 to 8 loops, whatever you want to call it, I would then recommend plugging it in with a metronome. Maybe you don't have an old-fashioned metronome like this. Maybe you've got a metronome app on your phone. I don't care. Use it. And remember, 3 beats per minute increases. So if you start at 80, practice at 80, and then your first increase should be 83. You'd be surprised how often in one practice session you can increase that metronome. For those of you who have been around on this channel from the beginning or for a while, you've probably heard me say those things a million times. But maybe one of you are watching right now who this is your first experience with me. Hello. The point behind the 3 BPM increase is to trick your brain. It's easy to get frustrated. Kind of gonna happen no matter what, but anything we can do to avoid that, I'm all for it. So that was something that one of my private instructors, when I was learning the drums, taught me. Increase in small amounts, but you can do it multiple times in one session. And it really helped. It was a game changer for me. And I know it'll be a game changer for you. Okay, that's really it. Part 3, open hi-hats within the beginner series. I hope you've enjoyed it. These grooves are fantastic. You can use them in rock, you can use them in pop, in funk, in R&B, really any genre, like some kind of ballad thing. Some of these grooves are kind of dance slash disco oriented. It's very versatile stuff, and it's important. It's important to have the open hi-hat as a part of your arsenal as a drummer, or as a, maybe that's not a good analogy, maybe as a, in your toolbox as a drummer. Anyway, thank you for being here. If you have any questions, as always, hit them in the comments below. Be more than happy to talk with you there. If I need to do a follow-up video to explain anything further, I will. If you enjoyed this video or any of the other videos on the Drum Shed, I'd be so grateful. I'd be so honored if you would hit the like button, do the YouTube-y things, subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet subscribed, hit the notification bell so you stay up to date on all the Drum Shed-y stuff. And if you know of a drummer who doesn't have a private instructor, maybe they don't have the means to have private lessons, or to take music classes, you might consider sharing this with them. That's the goal behind this channel, especially this beginner series, is I wanna help get drumming education out to people who maybe aren't able to take private lessons with anybody or can't take music classes. Well, hopefully this could be a somewhat helpful substitute. It's my honor that you've watched this video and that you're here with me today. I do not take it for granted. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a very blessed day.